Hi, I'm Dr. Willie McEther, Chancellor for Thomas Jefferson University at our Jefferson East Falls campus. Thank you for joining us for our third annual Rams Rise Up Challenge, Jefferson's Athletic Giving Day, where we rise together to support our student athletes. Our goal today is to raise support from 1,000 donors in a 24-hour period, and we're off to a strong start. Our athletes are among the smartest, most talented, and hardest working students in Division II. The NCAA has recognized Jefferson as a 9-time recipient of the President's Award for Academic Excellence. We're incredibly proud to share that our student athlete academic success rate is 98%, the second highest in Division II for 3 years in a row. Jefferson has a total of 79 NCAA tournament appearances, 38 CACC championships, 70 All-Americans, and 9 academic All-Americans. Our student athletes work hard and rise to the challenge all year long. And today, we're hoping you'll join them. Make your Rams Rise Up gift to support our Ram athletes. Be sure to check out our lineup of virtual events, including student athlete highlights, exclusive interviews, at-home workouts, and so much more. Thank you for joining us again. Let's go Rams.
It's just great having an environment where everyone has the same goal and everyone's friends, everyone's just happy to be there and just to compete with each other. And you can only do that if you're all in at the same time, if you're all there in the present moment. You know, we're trying to inspire each other, inspire other people, and change someone's life.
I've been playing my whole life since I was like 5 years old. The people around me, they motivate me, so it made it really easy to believe in myself. Not everyone gets this experience. I find myself getting extremely grateful. It doesn't come that easy. You gotta work for it.
You really have to be 110% committed to the sport. And I feel like when you're that committed to anything, it naturally becomes a part of you. When you have an event that everyone has to kind of come together for and reach a collective goal, I think that provides more of a community feel, a connection.
Being a student athlete and in life, it's challenging. There's lots of ups and downs, and you just have to push through them. It's just a drive in me. I really can't explain it. You can't teach it. You have to love the game to be in the game.
Hello, everyone. My name is Tom Shirley. I'm the Assistant Vice President for Athletics and the Head Women's Basketball Coach here at Thomas Jefferson University. I'm starting my 33rd year. For those of you that don't want to do the math, that's 1989 when I showed up, and still very happy to be here. Welcome to the third annual Rams Rise Up Challenge. We're very, very excited to have you participate today. We're happy to have you joining our festivities. It's been a great thing for athletics to be involved. Last year we topped the $100,000 mark, and we're certainly excited to try to move past that mark this year, and with your help, I feel confident that we can do that. The goal that the Office of Institutional Advancement set, being good coaches themselves, being very aggressive, is for 1,000 donors in a 24-hour period. So we're very, very optimistic that we'll not only meet that goal, but we can break that goal. No donation is too small. We're happy to have anything that you can afford to offer to our student athletes. The purpose of this is just to try to give them additional enhancements so as they go through their respective seasons, we can treat them a little bit here and there. We can buy some extra equipment for them, things that make their life a little bit easier and put a smile on their face. I also want to take a moment to thank Gina Gerton, who was the very first contributor to Rams Rise Up Challenge, class of 2011. We also had a few people donate during the week, mail some checks into the athletic department, again, which we really appreciate because every little bit counts. So thank you to those who have contributed in the past, and thank you to those that will consider in the future. The impact that your gift makes, I talked a little bit about that, but the seasons are long. Our students really get involved in sports when they come back in August, and they finish up sometime late April, and all through the course of the year, in some way, shape, or form, they're all participating. So the COVID obviously set us back last year. We only had a few teams participate in the spring, but we are back 100% this year. Women's tennis got to the finals. Men's cross country won the championship, and at this point in time, soccer season and volleyball season are finishing up. So we're excited for basketball season to begin, and certainly want to congratulate Coach McGee, who will now participate in his final season, 54 years as the head coach of the program, having come to Philadelphia Textile Institute in 1959 after graduating from West Catholic High School. So a lot of history, and we're certainly looking forward to his final season. Again, it's never too late to make a gift. Feel free. You want to think about it, you want to come back a little bit later, you want to make a gift to the one team and come back to another team, we're certainly happy to have that. Each team will be competing with teams of similar size, so there are some additional matches that teams can win if the participation levels are high enough. But I just want to close by saying thank you for everything that you've done for us in the past and you will do in the future. It benefits the student athletes. That's the main thing. It puts a smile on their face. It makes them happy. It gives them something that maybe they haven't had in their high school experience. So we're really appreciative of it. And we let them know all the time that this is something that came from fundraising. So we ask them to participate as well. And they ask their families and friends to get involved. So it's a joint effort. It's a community effort. And we certainly appreciate everything that you do. Hope you have a great Thanksgiving. And again, thank you for considering donating to our Rams Rise Up Challenge.
to the Jefferson East Falls campus. It's a beautiful fall day here. My name is Terrell Hinchman. I'm the Director of Fitness and Wellness. Today we're going to take a hike over in the Wissahickon. So we're very fortunate to have the location that we have. So basically you just walk straight across the bridge and you get into the Wissahickon Park. So it's about 1,800 acres, about 52 miles of trails. So we're just going to take one of those trails today so we can show you. Part of what it's like to be on campus. If you're ever on campus, definitely I suggest you take a trip over to Wissahickon. So, all right, come on with me. So right now we're on top of the Henry Bridge, so we're crossing over from the campus over to the Wissahickon Park. And as you can see, it is beautiful. Fall leaves. Gorgeous. Alright, heading over. Alright, so we just finished coming across the Henry Bridge, and right after the Henry Bridge, there's a tiny, tiny little path that we're going to go through in order to get onto the main trail, which is the yellow trail that we're going to go on today. Alright, so here we go. As soon as you get into the woods, it becomes so much more peaceful, leaving the traffic behind. It gets pretty loud on the bridge, but in here in the forest, just stress just floats away, right? Hey, good morning. How are you? Good. So we're now coming to the yellow trail. So you can either go right, that'll take you underneath the Henry Bridge, or you can go left. Some bikers coming up the yellow path. It's a pretty tricky path coming up here.
We're going that way, ladies. We're going this way.
So throughout the park they have these little guideposts that will show you kind of the different trails. So we're going to walk down to Forbidden Drive. If you were going to go the other direction, where we just came from, that will take you to the Lincoln Drive path. Alright, again this is the yellow trail. So this is above the Forbidden Drive. Which used to be a road that most of the cars went down about 50 years ago or more, and then it became forbidden to drive on, so then it became Forbidden Drive. So this path is actually above that, so it runs parallel all the way down. So this is the Lover's Leap, where we are standing currently. And I just wanted to get you a visual of what it looks like here. It's beautiful. It's actually one of my favorite places to have lunch, because it takes 2 minutes to walk across the bridge, and then you can sit up here in this loveliness. Alright, so we're going to go back on the path.
Thank you. Phil. All right, we're gonna warm up with some jumping jacks for about 30 seconds. Let's go. Split squats on the stairs. We have a railing in our stairs, and that's all you're gonna need. So I want you to put your back foot on a stair that's comfortable for you, Phil. And then I want you to sit on that foot. Yep, and then extend your leg out, and that's your stance, all right? And then from there, you're just gonna bring that back knee down and your front knee like you're squatting, all right? You should feel it in your butt and in your leg. All right, we're gonna do 10 of them for each leg. All right, ready? Go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Awesome. Same thing other leg. There you go. One. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Awesome, Phil. How are we feeling? Good. We're gonna do one more of them, and then we're gonna get into some push-ups. Are you ready? You need a breather? All right, same thing. Go. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Awesome. One, two, three. Now you can see Phil's helping himself on the railing, and that's fine. That's an assisted sort of Bulgarian split squat here. If you don't want it assisted, you can just put your hands to your side or on your chest just like this. Awesome, Phil. All right, you up for some push-ups? All right, so what we're gonna do is, if you need this assisted, you can be on your knees. We're gonna come to the ground, hands right at shoulder width, and our hands aren't coming out like this. We're gonna come in towards our body. Does that make sense, Phil? So we're not coming out like this. Our elbows are gonna be to our sides, all right? All right, we're gonna do 10 of them, all right, Phil? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And remember, you want to keep your butt straight. We don't want to be bending, we don't want to be curving, we want to stay like an arrow. Alright? Alright, Phil, why don't you show us the assisted version on our knees instead of on our toes. So it's the same thing. Our feet are just on the ground and so are our knees. It makes it a little easier. So if you're not as strong yet, we can do this at first. Perfect. Alright, we're going to do some inverted rows next. So all you need is the railing again. So what we're going to do is we're going to set ourselves up. It's okay that our hands are a little staggered here. If you can find a railing that's, you know, more flat rather than on a slant, that's fine, but this is fine as well. So you just want to set yourself up like this. You're going to fall back, and then you can use your back to pull yourself towards the railing. And what we're going to do to make sure that we're kind of evened out is we're going to have it this way, and then we're going to switch to the other side where our right hand was on top, and now it'll be on the bottom. And then that way it'll kind of compensate for both sides. You got that, Phil? Awesome. We're going to do 10 reps of that as well. Yep. 1, 2, 3. So the key here is not to use your legs and to use your back.
Hey, let's go, Phil.
And really push back your arms.
Hey, Phil.
Awesome. Other side. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Awesome. So that's all you need for your back. We're going to do some core, and then we're going to move into some triceps and some arms. First, what we're going to do is we're going to do the same exact thing as our push-up stance. It's going to be a high plank, where a high plank is just same as a push-up position, but you're just holding yourself up with your core rather than pulling yourself up with your chest. All right, Phil, you ready? We're gonna hold that 30 seconds. So you see how Phil is nice and straight? If he needs to, if you need the assistance, you can kind of push your butt up just like that, and it helps you out. You know, it takes a little less off the core. Puts a little bit more on your shoulders. But Phil is strong. Phil's gonna stay down for 15 seconds. Come on, Phil. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job, Phil. All right, next what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the railing again. And all we're going to do is set yourself up like a push-up position. And you're going to bend your elbows like this. So you're not using your shoulders at all. You're just bending your elbows. And that's going to be like a tricep extension. Bring your chin to the bar and then up. The farther away you are with your feet, the harder it will be for your triceps. The closer you are, the easier it will be. So you can come down real close. It's really easy. You can come out really far. That's a little harder. And we're going to do two sets so that we have the same kind of even thing where your top, whatever hand is on top, is going to be harder. So we kind of want to balance it out. Is that all right, Phil? Awesome. Thing, other side. 1, 2, 3. So it's exactly like a push-up, just the shoulders aren't doing the work and your chest isn't. It's more of your arms. Awesome. Good job, Phil. We got one more. You all right? Cool. So we're going to do sort of like a chin-up, but we're going to use the railing. So we're going to get under. we're gonna set up real close here. You sit down. So the farther your feet are, it's the same thing. The farther your feet are, the harder it'll be for your arms. But the closer they are, the easier it'll be. So what you have to do is just pull yourself up and kind of lean back at the bottom here. So what we're gonna try and do is work our biceps, and it's like a curl. Because we don't have any equipment and we're just using the railing, what we're going to do is lean back, curl ourselves up, that's all, let that help, awesome. So Phil's going to do it, same thing both sides, because the hands are in different positions, we want to make it even. There you go, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Awesome. Good job, Phil. Same thing on the side, and then we're done. My name is Dom. I'm at the Athletic Center in Service. If you guys enjoyed this video, it's a nice